So stay tuned for my music video, Let Me Be, which will be dropping tomorrow on Monday, August the 27th. I can't wait for you to see it. It's so special to me.
I don't have any friends. I'm all alone, trapped inside the confines of my beautiful mind, a prisoner between the boundaries of opposing realities. 'Cause I need someone, are you that someone? Go away now, I don't need no one. I need someone, are you that someone? Go away now, click the link in my bio.
I wrote that song as sort of like a preface to everything on the album, and that's why it's track one. It's this collection of thoughts. If you read it, it kind of reads like a stream of consciousness, and it's me like going back and forth between like, well, I don't have any friends, or like, no, there I go again, like, yes, of course I have friends, or like, they're just pretending to like me, and just kind of like trying to balance that. This beautiful collage of happy memories with my friends set to a song about how I don't have any, and I wanted to like use that as a way to remind myself or to come to terms with the fact that those nasty things that stream in my consciousness, those things aren't true. Maybe when you like experience trauma, you start to learn over time that life is traumatic and you start to expect things to go a certain way. And you feed so deeply into that delusion that sometimes they do start to go that way, and sometimes shit does get tough and traumatic and dark and ugly. But by and large, when I look around me, I don't see that stuff. That's behind. What I see when I look in front of me is an array of beautiful smiling faces, people who have been with me through this stuff, people who know about the things that hold me back and don't mind holding my hand and being patient and waiting for me to get through those tough emotions or come to the other side. And I'm grateful now that, you know, that I did put out that song and that music video and that I got to create something that captures that feeling. And then Puerto Rico happened.
Guys, it's me, Robin. We're going to Puerto Rico! Yay! Yay! Guys, show enthusiasm.
Motherfuckers, it's time.
Woo! We're going to the airport.
Guys, we're doing it. Guys, friends, we're doing it. We're going on a plane. Following Jen's lead. This was Jen's idea.
How do I flip it?
Shout out to my Jen. She really is my friend. Thought juice comes in a pouch here. 7-8 o'clock rolls around and I am out for the count. I am blackout drunk, ready for a nap, and I go to sleep. I go home and I go to sleep. I wake up at midnight, the house is empty, everybody is out partying, and I have my face in a toilet bowl and I am retching my entire soul out. I feel like I am on the brink of literal death. And I went back to sleep. I woke up the next day and everything was fine.
Good morning. Damn, my skin looks good. I'm just going for a walk to the local Walgreens to buy some pouches of alcohol at 6:30 in the morning. I just slept after not sleeping for 2 days straight. I had the single worst hangover of my life last night at like midnight. And I'm like nervously looking around to make sure people don't think I'm crazy, but I'm sure they think I'm crazy. I'm crazy.
And then I kept drinking and kept drinking and kept drinking. And I don't even know how it happened, but all of a sudden my drunk ass was screaming at the top of my lungs at a restaurant in public in Puerto Rico on a rooftop.
Out to Jen, right?
Like, this is for Jen. This is for Jen. We love you, baby. For Jen. Happy birthday, baby.
Thank you.
I don't even know what happened. Like, I still don't know what happened. I don't know what I guess it's just like the combination of the alcohol, which is a depressant, and the alcohol, which is a depressant, and the me, which is a depressant, and all of a sudden I was like, again, just out of my body. It's like I just vacate this vessel, and you know, it goes on autopilot, and like, you know, I just don't even know what happened or how this shit always fucking happens, but like, there it was again. Everything that I had been working for, all the progress I had making, it just felt like it went away. I'm like fighting with my friends and like screaming at people that I love. And it's like the worst feeling in the world when you're in such a beautiful place, surrounded by your closest friends, people that you love, and you just walk by them and they look at you like you're a stranger, or like they're afraid of you because you've given them a reason to be. And I hate that. And I don't want to be that for my friends. I don't want to be somebody that they feel like they have to walk on eggshells around, or like this time bomb that's just seconds from blowing up. I don't want to be that. And I wish I knew how not to be that. But I don't yet. I think I'm learning, because after that happened, that was like it for me. Like, it was my third episode back to back to back, and I was just like done with it, because at that point I found myself in another country, horrified at the behavior that I had just exhibited. I felt like I wanted to fucking die. I just wanted to end it all. While part of it is my PTSD and part of it is like these things that are not within my control, there are things that I can do to like keep stuff from escalating. Not binge drinking on medication. I needed to give everybody a little space from me. I needed a little space from me, and at that time it meant not talking and not hearing myself speak, not feeling like I had anything important to say, not making anything more about me than it already was. Everybody else went into the backyard to have a barbecue, and I didn't want to be there. I didn't want to burden anybody. I didn't want to be the obvious elephant in the room, and so I did what I felt was the only thing I knew how to do at that moment, and I shot a music video. Hi, Sal.
Hey, come to the pool. We're having a rousing game.
I will join you. Can I ask a quick favor?
Yeah.
I'm gonna sit on these stairs. Could you just press play on my phone or on your sister's phone in the bathroom? Here.
When do you want me to press play?
Can you just see if I'm in the frame?
It's actually playing right now.
No, yeah, that's recording, but the audio isn't. It's in the bathroom. I touched your speaker.
Okay. Say when.
You can do it. Thank you. I made this music video because I was feeling so pent up. I mean, granted, I just had the episode and I let everything out, but the aftermath comes with so much as well, and I'm just sitting in it and I'm feeling so disgusting and so disgusted with myself, and I'm like, I need to do something with this emotion. Like somebody who fucks up things, you know, like fucks up relationships or fucks up beautiful vacations or fucks up their best friend's birthday or X or Y or Z. In that moment, it just felt like, well, shit, I always fuck it up, and I know I'm gonna fuck it up because I always fuck it up, and so I had to make a video for fuck it up. And you know, the thing about fuck it up is, in hindsight, I can see that I was in the aftermath of a post-traumatic stressful episode when I made this video, because it is obscene. I mean, there is part of it where I'm fully naked, for the majority of it, I'm fully naked. And to be honest, I don't know if this music video is ever going to see the light of day beyond what I use in this documentary, but like, it was something. But you know, I'm glad that I made it. I'm glad that the music was able to swoop in that moment when I couldn't ask for anybody else's help, and it helped me. It helped me pass that time, because it surely wasn't easy, you know. I didn't want to bother anybody, but it wasn't easy for me to like sit inside listening to everybody having a great time in the pool and barbecuing and stuff. But I knew that it wasn't their problem anymore. It was mine. And so I went and I figured out something, I did something, and I distracted myself, and I made something, and we'll see how I feel about it down the line. But you know, for now it's just something that I made, and I'll have it, and I'll know that it helped me through that difficult time.
Hey guys, we're flying. Jen.
Take two.
This is actually three.
Christine. Where's Tiffany?
Over there.
Even though I didn't release Fuck It Up, I still shot that video, and I felt like, all right, maybe I need to release another single now, and maybe I need to do something. And so I took a step back, and I'm like, maybe it's time for me to put out subs.
It's Robby Rayy, and as usual, if you think it's about you, it is. Subs like the sandwich, bitch, you wish you had this. Footlong, long gone, get lost.
And I don't know, I it's like crazy how our perspectives change over time, but after that trip, I kind of just took a look at that video with new eyes and suddenly felt like it was the greatest thing in the world. And I still kind of feel like it's the greatest thing in the world. And so I threw it together and I cut a vocal and I put it out, and people really seemed to like it. And, you know, it put me in a place where 2018 was ending soon. I didn't make the album yet, but I had put out two more singles. I'd shot three music videos. I felt like it was time. Time to make the record, time to really heal, and time for change.